Hi there, this is Raahat. In this tutorial, we'll see how to perform some simple PRNU and SPN-based experiments in MATLAB. So this is your MATLAB window. In the middle there, it's the editor. This is where you write the code. On the left is a list of folders and files that you can access while you're running MATLAB. And on the right is the workspace. It holds all the variables that are created during the execution of codes. Now, for this experiment, I'll go to the folder that contains the test data and source codes that I need, this one, and let's just begin with frame extraction. So I start this code, and you'll notice that this is the same code that has been provided to you at the end of chapter 2. And let's say we want to extract frames from this video. So what we do is put the name of the video file here, create a folder that will hold the frames of this video, and then you run the code. Now you'll see the frames are now being extracted. Okay, and that's done. Let's take a look. So this is the folder, and yes, this folder now holds all the frames of this video arranged in a sequential order. All right. Now let's move on to PRNU based experiments. I'll start this code, calculation and correlation of PRNU. And again, this is the same code that has been provided at the end of chapter 2. And what I've done is put three separate segments of code in the same file. The first segment estimates reference PRNU from a single frame. The second segment estimates reference PRNU from a series of frames. And the third one helps correlate test PRNU with reference PRNU. So the way to execute it is, you take the part of the code that you don't want to run right now and you put it in comments, and you take the part of the code that you do want to run and take it out of the comments if it is in comments. Now put this part in comments as well. All right, now let's say we want to estimate reference PRNU from these frames. So open the folder, and we have 331 frames. All right, so we update the loop. The loop will go from the first frame to the 331st frame, and we'll do the same thing here. And then we, all right, run the code. So now it's estimating reference PRNU from these frames. And so this is the result. See, this figure one is noise residue for these series of frames, and figure two is your average noise residue for these frames, which we also know as PRNU. If you want to save these figures, now click on the save button and give this figure a proper name, select a folder, and from the drop-down list you can choose any format that you want, anything other than .fig, because figures that have the extension .fig will only be opened through MATLAB. So you can choose JPG or BMP, anything you like. And then you save it. All right, and then you do the same thing for all the other figures that you generate. All right, now PRNU is basically used for source camera identification, device linking. That's where we have to determine if the video in question was recorded by a particular camera, and that is done by correlating the reference PRNU of the camera and test PRNU of the given video. If the correlation is high, we say that the video in question was recorded using the given camera. Otherwise, we say that the given camera and the video do not link. So to see how device linking is performed, let's assume that we have a video of unknown origin, and we have extracted the frames of this video and put them here. So these are the frames of the video with the unknown origin. And we have two cameras under consideration, camera A and camera B. But we don't know which camera captured this video. Now we have two videos recorded by each of the cameras. Let's say that this video was recorded using camera A, and this video was recorded using camera B. So now what we do is we estimate reference PRNU from the frames of this video, and that PRNU will be referred to as the reference PRNU of camera A. And we estimate reference PRNU from the frames of this video, and that PRNU will be referred to as a reference PRNU of camera B. And then we perform device linking. So let's do that. First, what we do is we estimate reference PRNU for camera A from these frames. So there are 331 frames, so this is fine. And then we take this out of the comments. Now this mat file will contain the reference PRNU that you're about to estimate. So we'll give it a proper name so that it corresponds to a particular camera. All right, and then we run the code. So now it's estimating reference PRNU for camera A. We don't need the figures right now, we'll just close them and put them in comments. What we need is this reference PRNU, this one. Now this is the reference PRNU of camera A, and we repeat the same process for camera B using these frames. Okay, and we have 360 frames. We'll just update the loop. 360 there, and we change the name as well. Create a second mat file there, and now we run it. So again, we'll have reference PRNU of camera B, this one. Now that we have both the reference PRNUs, we're going to perform correlation. Now let's go to the folder which contains the frames of unknown origin. And before doing that, let's take these mat files that we just created and copy them in this folder. All right, and then take this one, copy it, paste it in here. Now, as you'll see, both the frames that we need to calculate test PRNU and the reference PRNUs that we're going to use for correlation are now in the same folder, right? Let's begin correlation. First, I will put this part of the code in comments. I don't need this anymore. And take this out of the comments. This is where correlation will be performed there. And right, so 250 frames, the loop is fine. First, let's do it with reference PRNU of camera A, which was in this mat file, right? So we're loading this mat file, and then we'll calculate test PRNU from these frames right here, and then we will correlate the two. So let's run the code. There you see, correlation values have been computed, and it's hard to make sense of these values. So a better way to do this would be to plot the correlation. Now you could plot correlation here as well to do this, or if you don't want to do that, let's just go to the workspace, right? So this is the variable, this is correlation, and there it is. So what we can do is plot the correlation from here, from the workspace. So right click on it and it gives you options. Let's just go with the simplest plot, the first one, this. Now what this plot represents is the correlation between test PRNU from these frames and reference PRNU of camera A. There we have the number of frames, and this axis is correlation, and it's at most 0.05. It's a little below that, which is very, very low, right? So this correlation is too low. Let's just save the plot for comparison later. We have to find out the same thing for camera B. So let's call it plot A. So plot A represents correlation of test PRNU and reference PRNU of camera A. And we save it in this folder and everything is fine. Okay, save. Now this figure is saved. Now let's repeat the same process, but with the second mat file, that is reference PRNU of camera B. So I'll change the name here. It will be, and run. It's calculating, and there you see list of correlations, and they seem pretty high So let's plot it again. Correlation, right click, plot. There, see, correlation reaches 0.9, which is very high, because a correlation of 1 indicates that the two items are exactly alike, and 0.9 is very high. So if we compare it with this one, see, so based on these plots, while the correlation of test PRNU and reference PRNU for camera A was not even 0.05, the correlation in this case is very high. With camera B, it's too high. So this tells us that the frames of unknown origin, the video of unknown origin, was in fact recorded using camera B, because the correlation between those frames, test PRNU of those frames and reference PRNU of camera B is very high. It reaches a maximum of 0.9. So that is how device linking is performed, right? Now, the SPN-based experiments are exactly similar to what we just did. The only difference is the equation that computes SPN, right? So everything else remains the same. And you can do similar experiments, PRNU and SPN-based experiments, using the same setup that we just discussed on any test data of your choosing. In the next video, we will perform some tests that we discussed in Chapter 4. I'll see you there.